to the Matrix with your boy, Prime Style. Let's get it. Thanks for dropping into the Saving of the Matrix with your boy Prime. I'm glad y'all could officially join me. Hope everybody is having a wonderful and lovely day. Well, I want to bring forth some information to the ones out there that really don't know too much information about NBA Live 16. The ones that really haven't played it, or the ones that really didn't really care for it at the time when it actually came out, or the ones that really didn't play the demo. So I'm going to bring stuff forward to a lot of individuals that's out there that don't know what's incorporated in the NBA Live franchise, or which was actually incorporated in NBA Live 16. So the thing with NBA Live that's always been good with the franchise has been always been authenticity. And authenticity means is that they always have everything that is real life, and they do it to the best of their abilities, and they are very, very good with it. Everybody knows about the Pro-Am, and everybody knows about what was incorporated. As you see, the 8 venues that you see are real life basketball courts that the Pro-Am is actually played on. And a lot of individuals don't know what Pro-Am means. Pro-Am means professional amateur. And this is where all the big ballers, you know, around the world actually play at the Pro-Am. And, you know, and like I said, even with this installment that was incorporated in NBA Live 16, the sky's the limit for the franchise and what it's going to entail moving forward. So, as you see, the cities as I'm going across everything. The first thing we're going to do, we're going to go into Toronto, Ontario, which is the Hoop Dome. And you see all the individuals that plays when you go up by level. And as you see the individuals that I'm going to play or play against. So, you know, you see the players. This is what you play against when you go up rank on each one. And then you see the pre-qualifier, the qualifier, the quarterfinal, the semifinal, and then the final at this particular venue. When you play these individuals, that's what you do. And the good thing about live is that it's the authenticity. And as you see people, and they have some individuals that are like local guys. And as you see, the real NBA Live players that I'm going to play, and these are actually Canada residents. So they have Canada residents, and that's the good thing, because they actually have the Canada residents that you're going to play. So that's very significant on what this does. As you saw, the players that resonated from Canada, or they played in Canada with the Toronto Raptors. So as you see, as you're looking, and I'm going to let everybody just look at the venue for themselves, and you take a peek, and then you go from there. And then I will be back momentarily. Now, I know y'all like the Hoop Dome, and as y'all saw that, so now we're going to go to Seattle, Washington, where the Seattle Pacific University. Now, this is a college, and this is a very good venue as well, and this is where this is a authentic gym as well. And as you see the players, as you go at the qualifier, and you saw the players, and as you see, now, this is significant enough, and as you see again, you see the players. I got Ray Allen, you have Kelly Olynyk, and you have Marvin Williams. So they resonated from Washington, or they played with the Seattle Supersonics. That's where reality, and these are guys that resonated from Washington themselves, from Seattle. So that's where they originated from, or their hometown. So, and as you see the way they have it categorized with the players, and you see the detail of the players, it's absolutely phenomenal. And this is something that a lot of individuals do not get to see when it comes down to the live franchise. And as you see the courts and the authenticity of the courts and what they look like. and the detail that they actually incorporated, as you see Jamal Crawford. So these are the individuals I'm going to play: Isaiah Thomas, Crawford, Levine, Ross, and Halls. So I will be back momentarily. Now we're going to go to the next venue and we're going to take a look at this as well. Now we're going to go ahead and head to Brooklyn, New York. And this is one of Brooklyn Park. And this is one of the top notch parks that you can actually play. And as you see some of the individuals, as I scroll down with the pre-qualifier, as you see some of the actual real players. And like I said again, people, it's authenticity with the real players. And as you see the squad, as we're going to go ahead and head up to Brooklyn, New York, and you see the squad. And this is the significance of, you know, the future of live. And as you see, I'm matched up with Kenneth Faried and I got Dwight Howard. But look at this squad. I'm going against Kemba, John Wall, Brandon Knight, Lance Stephenson, and Taj Gibson. Ooh! But as you see, people, with the significance of where you play the real players in the summer circuit, and it's not just when you get matched up with the actual, you know, individuals in the pro-am, it's when you get matched up in the summer circuit and what you actually do. And the summer circuit is something that is phenomenal because it's a real life event that actually goes down. Check out the court, everybody. I will be back with y'all in momentarily. Brooklyn was so nice. Brooklyn is nice. So what we're going to do, we're going to head on to San Francisco, California at the Kezar Pavilion. Now, this is a very, very good place as well, where we actually get to see an actual, the court is so beautiful. I mean, it's a very, very nice looking court. It's a big court, to be honest with you. It's a very, very big court. But, you know, again, the significance and the future of NBA Live is very, very high, people, with the authenticity. And I just want to bring this forth to everybody. And as you see the players, I'm matched up with Matt Barnes and Ryan Anderson. And some of the guys that you actually see that might be high rated, those are local players that are very, very good players as well, because they do have local guys. And look at this squad. Damian, Steph, Clay, Draymond, and Aaron Gordon. Ooh. Oh, God. But this is the significance of playing against the pros, and then you're playing against the amateurs. And that is the significance of the pro-am and what it does, you know. And again, it is so phenomenal how this is. And a lot of people miss this. Go ahead and check out the court, people. I will be back with y'all momentarily. Now, as y'all saw that, how Clay just did his little signature move, and y'all saw that. But this is, and now we're about to go to the one of the most popular parks in the world, which is in Harlem, New York, which is the Rucker Park, which they got this to a T. And I know a lot of y'all is like, dang, I did not know NBA Live had the actual parks that are actually in the game. Yes, they do. And they actually use the real life players. Graphically, NBA Live is phenomenal. And this is the thing that a lot of people miss out on NBA Live, is that not only visually that is absolutely good, you know, it's astonishing on how detailed that the game actually is. And as you see, I'm messed up with Vince Carter. I got Tariq Evans and I have Roy Hibbert. You know, and I'm about to go against Uncle Drew, Kemba, Kobe, Durant, and David Lee. Now, a lot of y'all forgot at the Rucker, and I can understand why Kevin Durant wasn't in some of the big names, because Kyrie's played at the Rucker. Also, Kevin Durant. Kevin Durant was at the Rucker as in a pro-am in the Drew League, and he scored 60 points in the game. So, you know, it goes down when you go to the Rucker. It goes down. They don't be playing when they at the Rucker. But I'm going to go ahead and let y'all look at the court, and then I'll be right back after y'all take a look at it. Beautiful, ain't it? So we about to go ahead and go from the East Coast, and we about to go all the way to the West Coast. We about to go to LA. So, and the good thing too that I didn't mention this is that look at the map. The location on the map of where everything is, that is the actual street. That is the actual location of the actual parks. They actually have the map of the actual parks, which is absolutely beautiful and phenomenal. But we about to go ahead and we about to go to Venice Beach. We about to go to LA. And as y'all see, I didn't finish it. I only got to part level 2. So that's all I can actually show y'all. But y'all actually see the players that you actually have to play in the quarterfinal, the semifinal, and the final. It's no joke when you play the summer circuit. It gets harder. And the good thing about the summer circuit, you actually got to play real life basketball. So I'm teamed up with Kawhi. No, I'm not. So I'm going against Giannis, Afalo, Paul Pierce, Kawhi Leonard, and Chris Anderson. Ooh, okay. Who I have on my team? I got Taj Gibson. I got Vucevic from the Orlando Magic. So that's the good thing about, you know, about the summer circuit. It gets harder the higher that you go up. And then the players actually play like their true counterparts. That is the most beautiful thing about it. So you really got to play real, real good basketball. And it's really, really fun when you play with five people against the pro players too, because you can get four other people and play in the summer circuit online. So go ahead and check out the court, people. I'll be right back with y'all after y'all take a look. All right. And as y'all saw, Swag, one of the members of the NOBC, he went to Venice Beach. He lives in LA. So he took a picture of Venice Beach while he was there, because he was balling. And like I say, off authentic. It's so amazing on how they got Venice Beach and how in detail that they have it. So we about to go ahead and go to New York. We about to go to Terminal 23. We about to go to Carmelo's building, and which is actually Team Jordan. So if you are with Team Jordan, this is where a lot of individuals with Team Jordan are, where they play. They play at Michael Jordan's gym. I don't know, Michael Jordan still goes to this facility and plays sometime. I don't know how much he plays now because he is older, but they do play. And I'm matched up with Joe Johnson, Paul Pierce, Greg Monroe, and Andre Drummond. Look at the squad. So that's the significance of it, and as you see on how beautiful it is. And at the Terminal 23, like I said, it's all Team Jordan. A lot of individuals, they do come out, and they do come out the ball. Sometimes Michael Jordan does be at his facility, but Melo really, really runs that terminal. And, you know, because he is Team Jordan. But like I said again, Team Jordan is in there. Go ahead and take a look at the court, people. I will be right back. Last but not least, we're going to Margaret He Ding Lin. Now, this court was actually incorporated, and I didn't finish this court as well, so I didn't finish the qualifier. I didn't really go through it yet, but I will. But they incorporated this with the third patch, you know, with the update. And as you see, some of the players right here, as you're looking at them right here, these are actually real life players. And Mark Waller, he actually passed away. EA did a tribute to him, and you know, they put them in the game, and they're no joke. But at the same time, you got to play these players. And like I say, these are all real life players. These are not players that are made up. And a lot of these guys are, they're real life players. But they incorporated this in the game on the patch, and they added this additional court. And you know, and it is in Chicago. And back in one of the episodes of the NOVC, I actually predicted that they was going to have a court from Chicago. Either it's going to be Chicago or it was going to be Miami. And I said, you know what, I'm going to stick with Chicago. And that's exactly what they did. They did a court from Chicago because it's a big city, so they had to go with a big market. And that's exactly what they did, and they put one from Chicago. But as you see the players, and you see all the rookies, and who I'm about to go against, and you see Jahlil Okafor, you know, Amon Livingston, and Will Bynum. So take a look at the court, people, and I'll be back with y'all momentarily. It is so beautiful and so visually astounding and so visually amazing on how good they actually did those venues and how they captured it. But I want to let y'all see some things too when it comes down to the edit player, when you actually on your created player, when you make your player. And as you see, that is actually me. And as you see, and a lot of individuals didn't really get a chance to do their face scan and, you know, get their face in the game. Some people actually did. I know a lot of individuals that got theirs. Some cats of the NL, some of the players of the NLVC, they did. Now, as you see with the body models, there are body types in NBA Live. Now, they only have five preset body types, but they do have body types in the game. Now, moving forward down with the technology that EA has incorporated and what they actually have, we may see some more body types and have body scans be incorporated in the future of NBA Live moving forward. Just letting everybody know that might be a significance because they're going to the sim direction, and that is what they're actually going for and what they're doing. And again, like I say, the authenticity has always been key when it come down to Live and what they incorporate and what they did with the program. And a lot of people have to understand that is real life. This is not something that is made up. I know this is an age of customization and people want to customize their own court, but you know, that's a good thing as well. But wouldn't you like to play on the real life facilities in the venues? You know, I feel that is something very, very important to do so instead of playing something that is made up. You know, yes, it's good to have a made up team and stuff. That's obvious. And you have your squad. But at the same time, it's good to actually play on the real life courts in the venues and have that atmosphere and that actual feel of a real life game in your press, you know, right in front of you. Well, this is your boy Prime. Thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix. If you know, you know. But if you didn't know, your boy Prime brought it to you. Oh, and before I go, just to let y'all know, when it came down to the Pro-Am and Live Run, EA, they incorporated the Live Run and the Pro-Am together. We had actually announced this on one episode of the NLVC to let everybody know that Live Run isn't Pro-Am. Live Run was incorporated in NBA Live 10. That is something that's a trademark of NBA Live. All right, y'all. I'm out of here. Hit me up on Twitter and subscribe to the channel. Peace.